You're a boy, and I reckon that you're challenging me. It's breeding season, isn't it? And I'm not going to compete with you during breeding season. I'm not interested in your girlfriends. I'm way too old. Yes, and I'm the wrong species. Out scouting for footage today for an upcoming set of videos about plogging the Karawatha Forest. I wanted to remind people that it's perfectly okay to walk there and then plog back. In fact, I just want to remind people that it's perfectly okay to just walk. You don't even have to run. Just enjoy this. Foam, PVC pipe, hand a drink, more PVC, beer bottle, light colored glass, plastic. What are you? How about a bike pedal? More plastic. A ball, for some reason. Plastic. I'm choosing to squat down rather than use one of those little hand things because I want the exercise, I want the mobility in my old age. So bending down helps with that. Both bending down like I am at the moment, oh, porcelain plate. And especially squatting down. Squatting down, so good. Hey lizard. These rocks are used for construction work on the trails over here. This is Kuraby bushland, that's Karawatha over there. Kuraby bushland barely gets used though, so I don't think the council's putting much money at the moment into that. Although I did talk to the councillor about it and she said she's still working on this area. Don't think that's needed anymore. This is why I carry all the time with me a set of emergency scissors. Notice how they're blunt at the end? Really safe. They use them for cutting seat belts and things like that in emergencies. And they fold up so beautifully. These are the old marking flags for when they did the work. Oh, there's another bit here. More rope. I think this rope is biodegradable though, it's not the plastic stuff, so it's good they're using that. I don't think these are biodegradable though, they're plastic. So here's a trick that I learned out filming on cotton fields out in Gundawindi. Whenever you got a pipe like this, just give it a kick. If it comes up heavy, it's probably got a snake inside. Snakes are heavy. These are obviously a set of the main power lines that come into this area of Brisbane. I don't recommend jogging on this. Slippery as hell. End up flat on your butt.
What are you?
I'm not going to worry about taking that back. This is just going to rust away. It is. Essentially, it's organic, isn't it? Although this is plastic. We all know about that, don't we? Got sweat running down my glasses. Let's see how hot it is. I don't think it's that hot. It's only 17 degrees. It's supposed to get to 28 today. So I'm lucky I'm out in the morning. It's only 7:25 in the morning. This here, that's Compton Road. On the other side is Karawatha. This is Kuraby Bushlands here. Karawatha Forest, I've got a real emotional connection to that because I know a family who were instrumental in saving that forest. I went out with their daughter. But would you believe that they even invited me over for Christmas for 1 or 2 years after we'd broken up? And I ended up going to her wedding. Great people, amazing. That family, they're Polish. And the grandparents came out to Australia as refugees after World War II. I don't know whether all Polish people are as amazing and caring as they are, but I do know that they really instilled in me a care for the environment and the concept of sacrifice for the purpose of maintaining the environment. Because they went through a lot to be able to save Kuraby bushland on the other side of this fence. So this here, this is an overpass to allow the wallabies to go over. There's small trails there across there. Humans don't tend to go across there much. Then along here, this is koala fence. And if you look up there, there's ladders for koalas to cross from Kuraby Bushland on that side to the Kuraby Bushlands over here. So effectively, they are two sides of the same habitat. This is the overpass that I talked about. So if you have a look over here, you see Compton Road heading up that way. And then over here, there's Compton Road heading out to the east. So east, west, Kuraby Bushlands. Sorry, Karawatha Forest, Kuraby Bushlands. We could go this way, but I'm gonna go back because I wanna go to the visitor's center when it opens. And I think it opens at 9, it's 7:35 now. This is the Wallaby Trail. Down there further, there's an underpass for possums and things to get through. They've got rails on the wall, so the possums can go across that even when it's flooded underneath. How do sauce containers get down here? I honestly don't know. Ooh. Apparently these are tasty. Rubber from a blown truck tube. I know I've been promoting walking while plogging, but I better start running. I gotta get back in time to get a few other things done today. I may be a teacher on holidays, but still got things to do. Interesting thing is that my doctor gave me a phone call yesterday. So I had a whole heap of blood tests done when I was sick with influenza. And she said to me that while I was in Uganda, I managed to pick up a parasite through my feet, but that my immune system seems to be coping with it. Actually, I've had an idea. My YouTube channel is basically languishing. I'm not using it at all. When I edit this stuff, I put it together into an unmarked version, edit out all the stuff I don't want, and put it into an unmarked version. I might just upload that to YouTube, because you never know. Some people might want to watch just the details of this stuff and me prattling on. Just had another brilliant idea. I think I should call it something like Plogging Almost Raw or Plogging Almost Naked. People would watch that. Well, no, they're not going to watch me running naked, but they might think it's someone else. I don't know. So we're plogging almost naked. This is a really nice part. Goes down to a swamp down there and then follows a stream up in this direction here. Thing is, all the rubbish from Kuraby Forest up here tends to wash down here and pushes up against the fence of a development on this side. So this is that fence that butts up against the housing estate on that side. So that's Kuraby Forest there, Kuraby Bushlands. Kangaroos come through there. There's one running over there now, I can hear it. So this is where it comes out of the swamp. Got to watch out for red-bellied black snakes here. So down here, you can see the trees have pushed through here during floods. And the rubbish tends to get washed down into here. But I did clean this up down here not that long ago. So that's probably why there hasn't been a flood since then. So up here. Okay, there's turtles in here. Snake-neck turtles. And probably water dragons as well. I'm pretty sure I've seen water dragons here. Time to go home. See you, red-bellied black snakes. See how this tree's been washed straight through the fence by the flood? I wonder whether it'll flood this summer. It's supposed to be another La Nina year, little girl. So I suppose the flooding is probably better than the bushfires. We're expecting bushfires, and I think I'd rather flooding than bushfires. There's a proper passageway for the wallabies, and I got a cobweb on my hat. This whole hill is good for getting the heart rate up. Sometimes I run up it, but I don't think I need to today. And we're almost out. Come on, Trinity.